वेलकम टू अवर चैनल। आज हम 8th क्लास का और फास्ट का जो है सेकंड बुक का फर्स्ट चैप्टर करने जा रहे हैं, वीवर्स, आयरन स्मेल्टर्स एंड फैक्ट्री ऑनर्स। इसके क्वेश्चन आंसर देखेंगे हम, ठीक है। व्हाट काइंड्स ऑफ क्लोथ्स हैड अ लार्ज मार्केट इन यूरोप? ऑल फाइनली वोवन टेक्सटाइल, कॉटन क्लॉथ, प्रिंटेड कॉटन क्लॉथ एंड सिल्क क्लॉथ हैड अ लार्ज मार्केट इन यूरोप। सेकेंड वन है, व्हाट इज जामदानी? जामदानी इज अ फाइन मसलिन ऑन विच डेकोरेटिव मोटिव्स आर वोवन ऑन द लूम, टिपिकली इन ग्रे एंड व्हाइट, ऑफन अ मिक्सचर ऑफ कॉटन एंड गोल्ड थ्रेड्स वॉज यूज। द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट सेंटर्स ऑफ जामदानी वीविंग वर ढाका इन बंगाल एंड लखनऊ इन द यूनाइटेड प्रोविंस। वन है, व्हाट इज बंडाना? Bandanas refers to a brightly colored and printed scarf for head or the neck. Actually, this term is derived from the word bandana and it is referred to many bright colored cloths produced through a method of tying and dyeing. Next one hai hamara, who are the Agariya? Agariyas were the men and women of Bihar who were carrying basket loads of iron ores. Charles Wells and Jamsetji Tata traveled in the forest one day and came upon a small village of Agariyas. Fill in the blanks dekhenge. The word changed come from the word dash, chint. Tipu's swords was made of dash steel, yani ki wood steel. India's textile export declining in the dash century, 19th century. Next dekhiye, how do the names of different textile tell us about their histories? First of all, the European traders came to know about fine cotton cloths of India, which was carried by the Arabian merchants in Mosul in present day Iraq. So they started calling muslin to all finally woven textile, as muslin was a word that acquired wide currency. Portuguese arrived at Calicut in search of spices. They started to call calico to cotton textiles along with spices, which they took back to Europe. Then calico became the general name for all cotton textiles. European orders to bulk the piece of printed cotton cloth called chint, causes and bandana. Chint derived from Hindi word chint, a cloth with small and colorful flowery designs. In the same way, bandana derived from word bandana, which means many bright colored cloths produced by a method of tying and dyeing. Next one hai hamara, why did the wool and silk producers in England protest against the import of Indian textiles in the early 18th century? The British wool and silk producers were unable to compete with Indian textiles, as the English producers wanted to a safe and secure market within the country by preventing the entry of Indian textiles. That's why they protested against the import of Indian textile in the early 18th century. So the British government passed few laws. One of such law was Calico Act. How did the development of cotton industries in Britain affect textile producers in India? First one dekhiye iska answer. Industrial revolutions came in Europe and they themselves started to produce a lot of textile goods. That's why export of Indian textile declined. Second one, textile goods made in industries of Europe were they cheap and goods in quality as compared to the Indian textile. That's why export of Indian textile also declined. Third one, European countries imposed heavy taxes on Indian goods of textile so that they could become more expensive. Gradually, their sale was decreased and export was also declined. In this way, development of cotton industries in Britain affect textile producers in India. Why did the Indian iron smelting industries decline in the 19th century? Answer dekhiye iska. First one, one of the reasons of decline of Indian iron smelting industry in the 19th century was the New Forest laws passed by the British. As colonial governments prevented peoples from entering the reserve forest, they were unable to find woods for charcoals. They were unable to collect woods so long by defying forest laws. So many gave up their crafts and looked for other means of livelihood. Next, third one dekhiye. In some areas, governments granted the peoples to enter the forest, but they had to pay very high tax for every furnace they used. It reduced their income. Moreover, they faced new competitions from the British manufacturers. That's why Indians' iron smelting industry declined in the 19th century. Move to the next question. What problems did the Indian textile industries face in the early years of its development? Indian textile industries faced the following problems in the early years of its development. First one, the British started exporting its cheap and good quality textile to India. It became very difficult for Indian textile to compete with cheap imported textile from Britain. Second one, generally government supports its industries by imposing heavy duties on imports. It eliminates competitions and protects newborn industries. But the colonial governments in India refused to give such protections to local industries. What helped ISCO to expand steel productions during the First World War? इसकी अथवा में क्वेश्चन पूछ सकते हैं और में वाई द गवर्नमेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया वॉज डिपेंडेंट ऑन टिस्को आफ्टर द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर। ठीक है, इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन बनता है। तो देखिए इसका, इन इट्स अर्ली डेज टिस्को फेस्ड स्टिफ कंपटीशन फ्रॉम द ब्रिटिश स्टील मैन्युफैक्चरर्स, बट द फर्स्ट वर्ल्ड वॉर ब्रोक आउट इन 1914, द ब्रिटिश स्टील प्रोड्यूसिंग कंपनीज नो हैड टू मीट द डिमांड्स ऑफ वॉर इन यूरोप, दैट्स वाई इम्पोर्ट ऑफ द ब्रिटिश स्टील टू इंडिया डिक्लाइन स्टडली, दैट्स वाई इंडियन रेलवे लुक टुवर्ड्स टिस्को फॉर द सप्लाई ऑफ स्टील। वॉर कंटिन्यू फॉर 5 years एंड टिस्को हैड टू प्रोड्यूस कैरेज व्हील्स एंड शेल्स फॉर द वॉर। बाई 1919 90% ऑफ स्टील मैन्युफैक्चर्ड बाई टिस्को वॉज बींग बोट बाई कॉलोनियल गवर्नमेंट। दैट्स ऑल फॉर टूडे, थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे। Thank you.